A senior space agency official told Reuters that NASA wants Elon Musk's SpaceX to ensure that its plan to launch its next-generation Starship rocket from Florida does not jeopardize nearby launch infrastructure critical to the International Space Station. The new obstacle complicates and may delay the rocket's launch plan, which is already subject to a lengthy regulatory review at its primary launch site in Texas. Musk wants to demonstrate to customers that Starship, which he sees as humanity's path to Mars, can successfully reach orbit, a long-delayed turning point in the rocket's development. SpaceX's proposals to address NASA's concerns, including a plan to launch U.S. astronauts from a different launchpad in Florida, could take months to receive agency approval. Last year, SpaceX accelerated the construction of an orbital Starship launchpad at its facilities in Cape Canaveral, Florida. As an alternative to the rocket's primary test launch and development site in Boca Chica, Texas, which is currently undergoing a lengthy regulatory review that is set to conclude next week. However, one of SpaceX's current Florida facilities, Launch Complex 39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center, on the coast of Cape Canaveral, is the only pad authorized to launch the company's Crew Dragon capsule. NASA relies on that spacecraft to transport astronauts to and from the International Space Station. NASA officials have recently informed SpaceX that a Starship explosion at Launch Complex 39A could effectively shut down the space agency's sole means of launching American astronauts to the International Space Station. We all recognize that an early failure, such as we experienced on one of the first SpaceX flights, would be devastating to 39A. NASA's Space Operations Chief, Kathy Lutters, spoke about the agency's discussions with SpaceX in an interview. A request for comment from SpaceX was not returned. SpaceX has already invested heavily in the construction of a Starship pad, hundreds of feet away from Pad 39A's launch tower. According to a person familiar with the plans, it has responded by pitching NASA on a plan to outfit its other Florida pad, Launch Complex 40, located 5 miles away on Space Force property, with the capability of launching U.S. astronauts. According to Lutters, the company is also researching ways to harden 39A, or make the launch pad more resistant to both an explosive Starship accident and the immense forces emitted by a successful Starship liftoff. Both hardening the 39A pad and launching humans from Pad 40 would require approval from the agency. SpaceX is collaborating with us on those issues, Lutters said, because it's also in their best interest not to have what is a fairly consistent source of income for them disrupted. Part of SpaceX's challenge is to demonstrate that 39A will not be harmed by Starship's novel liquid oxygen and methane fuel, a propellant combination that NASA and U.S. regulators are unfamiliar with. The problem is that the explosive potential of that combination is unknown, said Randy Repchek, a deputy manager in the FAA's Office of Commercial Space Transportation, which oversees launchpad safety. Starship is a two-stage reusable rocket system that will launch commercial satellites into Earth orbit, as well as humans to the Moon and Mars. NASA chose SpaceX last year to use Starship for the agency's first launch of U.S. astronauts to the lunar surface since the Apollo mission. The rocket's next major test, a hard task of launching to orbit for the first time, has been pushed back. In part due to a regulatory examination of the Texas compound's environmental impact, which has prevented the FAA from awarding SpaceX an orbital launch license. The investigation, which is scheduled to end on Monday, is expected to impose constraints on SpaceX, potentially delaying the Starship program. Musk doubled down last year on the construction of Starship's launch pad at 39A in Florida's Cape Canaveral. We do have the Cape launch tower as an alternative, and we actually applied for environmental approval for launch from the Cape a few years ago and received it. Musk said at a Starship update event in February, estimating it would take 6 to 8 months to build up the Cape launch tower and launch from there. However, preparations for Starship continue on the East Coast, both at the Roberts Road and LC-39A locations. A few months ago, Elon shared a render of how the Roberts Road complex will look once all significant work is done, and this cosmetic work can be seen on that same corner of the Hangar X building. It also shows the opening for vehicles to enter and exit High Bay 3 will be on the north side, and the Starbase factory will feature two different roof heights, likely to accommodate nose cone and payload bay stacking. However, these plans appear to be somewhat fluid from a final design standpoint, with NSF's Harry Stranger spotting updated schematics of the Roberts Road factory plan, which could actually include two high bays. Development of the ground systems required to test and launch the spacecraft at 39A continues as usual. The large cryogenic tank at 39A is now more than double the height when we last flew, and construction has begun on another tank to the north of this new tank. It seems to use a more traditional design due to the location, but I wouldn't do that. I'd be surprised if this is an additional methane tank, but we'll have to wait. Looks like it's on the south side of this tank. The newly upgraded hydrogen, which has recently been converted to a methane balloon, is completely white compared to the last flight and is now shiny. As the repairs progressed, a new set of transport lines was a good sign, stretching south of the methane tank field where the launch site was located. In satellite image 39A, we can see all of this progress from an orbital perspective, and we can see a new supercooler added next to the large cold tank, lending weight to the hypothesis that it is part of the LOX tank spacecraft farm. The blocking balls that SpaceX is currently using on 39A to launch the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy have not worked at all over the last month. It seems that there is another additional facility at the oil depot, similar to the one under construction in Boca Chica. The cryogenic bunkers will house all the key components needed to control and dose the propellant and other products needed for the tower and orbit. Boosters during testing and launch. In these two satellite and flight images, we can see strange tubes and other structures added to the octagonal structure of the old spacecraft. Mystery of the past. Based on all of the above, I wanted to make it clear that it is a complete speculation. That the launch of the spacecraft in Florida will take place at least a year from now, and the schedule may need to include the ship. Not based on bugs, no, I don't think they will fly boats or boosters with a Boca Chica bow. Used by Boca Chica to control the barge. Too long or too short. Or write us your opinion in the comments. Not all 39A, but Falcon 9 is missing because of the track. Nearby, several supports for GSE lines are also visible to the north of the launch tower, and over at the former Starship landing site by the two tents. Following the utilization of Starbase and 39A, SpaceX will then work on additional options, such as two pads at LC-49 and its two ocean platforms, Phobos and Deimos. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.